Hello students, welcome to the class on current affairs, and in this class I will be dealing with double taxation avoidance agreement. Now this double taxation avoidance agreement is in news because recently India has redone the double taxation avoidance agreement with Cyprus. We have actually revised this DTAA with Cyprus. First of all, we need to understand what is meant by double taxation avoidance agreement and why India has resorted to such kind of agreement with various countries. Now, double taxation avoidance agreement. So, this is an agreement that is signed with various countries in order to avoid the people who are doing investment in India, and this investment that is done in India is generally done from the developed countries and from such countries where the rate of taxation is very less. So the purpose, the intent behind this double taxation avoidance agreement was to encash on the investment, because India was really thirsty about investment. India required a lot of investment. There was investment required in infrastructure development. There was investment required in telecommunication sector. There was investment required in power sector. There was investment required in energy sector. And this is the reason why India had entered into double taxation avoidance agreement with various countries. So this was basically done to kind of providing ease to the investors so that investment could move at a pace. But now what India is doing, India is actually redoing this double taxation avoidance agreement with various countries. India is actually revising these agreements that India has signed in the past. Like, we have already revised this double taxation avoidance agreement with Mauritius, and now we are trying to do the same with Cyprus. The important thing to understand and know why India is revising this double taxation avoidance agreement. Now, India is actually feeling a pinch of the lower collection of the taxes. The taxes that comes into the kitty, that comes into the coffers of the government of India, that comes in the coffers of the, under the consolidated fund of India, it is actually shrinking. Now, why it is shrinking? It is shrinking because the investors, the domestic investors, they are actually misusing this double taxation avoidance agreement. Suppose I am an investor and I am settled in India and I want to do investment in India, and I know that the rate of taxation, that this capital gains tax or various other taxes, it is high in India but it is less in case of Mauritius. So what I will be doing, I will be shifting my office to Mauritius, and from Mauritius I will be doing investment in India. So whatever the profits I will be making out of this, they will be liable to be taxed at a lesser rate, because the rate of the taxation is less in Mauritius, rate of the tax is less in case of Singapore, rate of taxation is less in case of Cyprus. So basically what I was doing, I was actually carrying all my resource out of India, I was investing it in Cyprus, and from Cyprus again I was investing it back in India. So this was a kind of round tripping that I was doing. I was actually misusing. So the kind of the investment that came in India, it came in India out basically from these three or four countries. So most of the FDI that has come into India after 1990, it has come from these countries like Mauritius, like Cyprus and Singapore. Now basically India wants to increase its tax collection, and because of that India is revising these double taxation avoidance agreements. Now what will be the outcome once these double taxation avoidance agreements will be revised. Like we have already revised in case of Mauritius. So in case of Mauritius, India will be able to tax the capital gains that will be taking place in Mauritius and in Cyprus. Now suppose an Indian company merges with a Mauritius company or an Indian company merges with a Cyprus company. In that case, there will be a capital gain done on the part of the Mauritius company and on the part of the Cyprus company. But as per revised double taxation avoidance agreement, now government of India can tax these capital gains. But when we compare the revised tax, this double taxation avoidance agreement between Mauritius and between Cyprus, it is the Mauritius double taxation avoidance agreement which is still more favorable in comparison to Cyprus. Now what is the reason of this? Now Cyprus has been one such country that has not been receptive to the idea of sharing tax information with India. And this is one of the reasons that it was placed under notified jurisdictional area. Notified jurisdictional area. Now what is this notified jurisdictional area? Cyprus was placed under this category, notified jurisdictional area. Now notified jurisdictional area basically means that government of India will be taxing any kind of payment that will be moving out from India to Cyprus. Agar koi bhi paisa Hindustan se Cyprus mein move hoga, to Indian government uske upar tax lagayegi kitna 30% ka. ऐसा क्यों किया गया? क्योंकि साइप्रस एक ऐसा देश है जिसने 2013 के पहले मना कर दिया था कि वो कोई भी टैक्स इंफॉर्मेशन इंडिया के साथ शेयर नहीं करेगा. जितने भी ये कंपनीज हैं, अगर वर्ल्ड वाइड देखा जाए, जितना भी मल्टीनेशनल कॉर्पोरेशंस हैं, अगर उनका टोटल किया जाए कितना टैक्स ये अवेड करते हैं, इट कम्स अराउंड टू बी 270 billion. सो दिस much amount of tax is not paid to the sovereign governments. Now how these companies end up paying less tax? These companies, they end up paying less tax by resorting to various kind of maneuverability of the taxation laws. They actually maneuver with these taxation laws. They actually play with these taxation laws. Like they resort to round tripping. Like they resort to base erosion and profit shifting. What is base erosion and profit shifting? These companies, they actually show as if they have not made enough of profit. They actually erode their base erosion and profit shifting, or they will show that they have to pay lot of amount in royalty to some other company, or they will show that their companies have actually disintegrated. They will actually divide their companies into n number of parts. Now why this disintegration of a company is done? Suppose you have a company and this company is liable to pay 2 billion of tax. But if this A company will be divided into B and C company, and further C company is divided into D and E company, then the total amount of the profit that will be liable to be, on which the tax has to be paid, it will actually be reduced. So these are the kind of the things that these companies generally resort to, and they end up paying lesser of tax. Now there's a fight going on between the corporate class and between the sovereign governments. Now the corporate class, they want to avoid tax evasion and tax avoidance, and there are sovereign governments who want to collect more and more taxes. Now OECD company, OECD organization, it actually wants to work on this base erosion and profit shifting. It actually wants to come out with such global tax laws so that these multinational corporations, they are taxed in a better manner so that they don't end up evading and avoiding taxes. So this was all for the day. Bye bye, take care, have a nice day.